we shall reflect on the life of Saint Maximilian Mary Kolbe. Baptized Raymond, Saint Maximilian Mary Kolbe was born in Poland on the 8th of January 1894 to Julius and Maria Kolbe. As a young man, he entered the order of Friars Minor Conventuals and was ordained priest in 1918 in Rome. Burning with a filial love for the Virgin Mother of God, he founded an association called Army of Immaculate Mary and later the Knight of the Immaculate, a religious magazine under Mary's protection for the purpose of disseminating the good news more widely, both of which he propagated in his native land as well as in other countries. In the year 1930, he went as a missionary to Japan, working under the mantle of protection and patronage of the Immaculate Virgin. He set up printing presses and founded a community to carry on his work of evangelizing through printed word. Returning to Poland in 1936, he became director of Poland's chief Catholic publishing complex, thus incurring the wrath of the Gestapo in 1939, and thus he was imprisoned for his anti-Nazi propaganda, and then he was released and once again rearrested in February 1941 for aiding Jewish refugees during the World War II, and he was then deported to Auschwitz. Here it was that, true to his name, which meant greatest in Latin, his heroism shone bright. On the 24th of July 1941, one of the prisoners in the concentration camp escaped. As a result, in keeping with the practice followed there, 10 men were selected at random to die of starvation in an empty bunker. One of these, named Franciszek Gawaszek, a father of 9, wailed, "No God, not me, please. What will become of my poor wife and children?" Deeply moved, Father Kolbe stepped out of the ranks and, standing before the commandant Fritsch, he pointed to Sergeant Gejowczyk and said, "I am a Catholic priest from Poland. I am old. I want to take his place because he has a wife and children," thus exemplifying Christ's redemptive love. As at the camp, Father Kolbe continued to be the source of strength and comfort for his fellow condemned, diligently preparing them to meet their end, praying and singing praises to the Lord instead of weeping in despair. It was not long before death took its toll on those long, emaciated bodies. Father Kolbe alone remained. It was August 1941. The cell being needed for the next batch of the condemned, his death was hastened with an injection of carbolic acid. Whereafter, his remains were found to be in a state of illumination in the dark cell before being cremated. Maximilian had prepared himself for this final sacrifice that made him the symbol of the triumph of good over evil by following Christ closely from the very first years of his life. Consequently, his mysterious childhood vision of the two crowns came to fruition when he received the white crown denoting purity at the hands of Pope Paul VI, who beatified him on the 17th of October 1971, and the red one symbolizing martyrdom when he was canonized by Pope John Paul II on the 10th of October 1982.